In today's video, I want to discuss the differences between European and, in particular, Italian skincare products and American skin products. So I was born and raised in Italy, and I recently spent 2 weeks there, just to visit my family. And of course, as I was there, since I'm very passionate about skincare, I started to go around Sephora or a drugstore to see what these stores have to offer in terms of skincare. And you're probably gonna be surprised by what I found out. So let's talk about this a little bit more in details after the intro. Okay, so the first difference that I noticed is that Italians or European, when they want to buy skincare products that are considered of high quality and that supposedly work very well, they don't go to the Sephora, but they actually go to the drugstore. In the US is different, meaning that products that are sold at the drugstore are considered of lower quality compared to high-end brands that you find at Sephora. Also, I visited several Sephora in Italy, and all the sales representatives there are extremely aggressive, which is something that honestly I couldn't stand. And I've been told that that's their policy, so that's another thing that is different. The second difference is that Europeans focus more on creating products that are suitable for sensitive skin. They focus a lot in creating products that do not damage the skin, while Americans focus more on making products that give you benefits. So in Europe, you see a lot of products tell you what they don't contain, for example metals or other irritants such as fragrances of essential oils, while in the US it's difficult to find the same attention and to these kind of details as far as sensitive skin, but there's a lot more attention to ingredients for their benefit. In particular, one ingredient that in the US is super popular and it's not the same in Europe is retinol. A lot of skincare products in the US contain retinol, which is the most common anti-aging ingredient, and people even use prescription retinoids as anti-aging. This does not happen in Europe. I've never talked to anyone that uses prescription retinoids for anti-aging over there, which is a shame, I know. And again, the whole focus is more on preventing something from happening compared to treating something that is already there. I've also noticed that it's very hard to tell what are the ingredients in a European product, unless of course you read the ingredients list. So they focus on on the packaging, they focus on describing what the product does compared to what the product contains. So in Europe and with European skincare brands, you will never see a packaging that says something like 10% vitamin C, pH level of 3. you will see something that says fights hyperpigmentation or fights dark spot. But even there is no so much attention to skin issues like hyperpigmentation. Everything is more targeted to anti-aging and general hydration and or repairing the skin barrier. So this is another important difference. Another thing that I have noticed is that the average European couldn't care less about the formula of the product, and they are very old school, meaning that I heard this skincare advice that was kind of obsolete and very, very old. Kind of like the same skincare advice that my grandmother would give me. While in the US there is so much more innovation while still keeping tradition. Another difference that I have noticed is that Europeans have scents that are typical for their territory, while Americans tend to use more synthetic fragrances. For example, especially when it comes to Italy, Spain and Greece, or even France, you will have a lot of scents that are derived from the typical herbs of the territory, for example thyme, lavender, or citrusy smells. Conversely, in the US, you find that most products contain synthetic fragrances. So after all this, you might be tempted to think that I consider American brands or in general American skincare to be superior to European skincare. And I have to agree, in my opinion, skincare in the US is better because there is more, it's more transparent, and consumers have the opportunity and the knowledge they need to make their decisions, while in Europe is still a lot, you still have to rely a lot on the person that is selling you the product unless you have some skincare knowledge on your own. But again, they just make it very difficult for you to understand what the active ingredient of a product is. This is something that I don't like. But there are two European products that I consider a lot better compared to any of the US products. These are sunscreen and deodorants. So sunscreen, European sunscreen, there is this this say that European sunscreen is better, and I confirm, European sunscreen, it is on a different level compared to all sunscreen formulations here in the US. Here it's hard to find a sunscreen that's not greasy and not sticky, and let's not even talk about the mineral sunscreen that I literally cannot stand. In Europe, conversely, it's almost all formulas I have tried, even the cheapest one, even the one from the drugstore, are definitely super lightweight. They call them milk, sunscreen milk, and they have this milky texture, super lightweight, very liquid, and is something that is fast absorbing. Also, the components and the UV filters that they use are different compared to the US. This is because there are some sunscreen filters that are approved in Europe and are not approved in the US. So that is the reason. But there's another product that I have to say Americans don't know how to do it, and this is deodorant. If you go to Target or any other drugstore in the US, you find a lot of antiperspirant or natural deodorant, all deodorants that are not natural but simply don't work, meaning that they just contain perfume which covers up the smell but not really, instead of actually erasing it. In Europe is a total different story. In fact, every time I go, I buy at least 10 or more. I stack up on deodorants. And this is because European deodorants work very well. And some are even alcohol free, so they are not irritant to the skin, but still work amazingly well and are really able to erase all odors. So these two are the two products that I really think you should buy in Europe. Everything else, you're probably gonna be fine buying everything in the US. Like I said, European products, in my opinion, tend to be a little bit diluted, and like I said, you can't really tell what's inside unless you spend hours perusing the ingredients list. While in the US, ingredients lists are shorter, more compact, and most of the times you know what's inside the product just by quickly reading the label or the description on the website. This is it for this video. I know it was a little bit different than the others, but I just wanted to give you a different perspective since I am European and I live in the US, but you know, I just cannot forget where I come from. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.